All right, everyone, what's going on? It's Abe. I'll be your coach again for today. And today we're going to start off with a warm-up. Today's warm-up will be nice, and it will be going through the same motions we will be going through in the actual workout itself. So for the warm-up to start, we're going to start with 50 singles. Jump rope is one of the best ways to get your cardiovascular system going and get everything moving. If you don't have the rope, we're gonna start, well, first, if you do have the rope, we're gonna start with 50 singles, right? Followed by 50 double unders. And if you don't, if you're not really adept with the double unders, remember where you're doing two spins in one hop, right? You can do 100 singles, which will, in total, will equate to like about 150 singles, all right? The singles, they will just be, remember, feet are gonna be close apart, they're not gonna be too wide out, and this is not gonna be, we're not gonna be bending at the knees. So if it looks without the rope, it's gonna look essentially like this. This is a calf dominated workout here, keeping nice and straight at the torso as well, not leaning forward, not hyperextending back either. And the elbows are not flared out, they're gonna be close, tucked into your rib cage. So for your singles, like this. The double unders is essentially the same principle, except we're gonna be jumping a little higher for the doubles. You're gonna keep the elbows in, and you're gonna flick a little more by the wrist. And that's kind of the secret there. All right, that's gonna be the doubles. Guys, that's all practice, remember. So that's all cognitive function there. So you guys basically go to sleep at night, come back, learn it, and you'll get it probably right as rain the next day, all right? So just keep at it. Practice makes perfect, guys, all right? If you do not have the ropes at hand, you can do line hops. You can just essentially put a line on the ground and then just kind of hop over it, or you can do it over an object. So I have chosen this object here in particular, all right? So what I will be doing is I'll just be going over here, and then you will just be hopping side to side, all right? Down, up, all right, 50 of those. And then immediately after, you could take a small like 10 second break, and then immediately after, go right up within another 100, all right? Another 100 we're gonna get, should be nice and pumped at that point. And then after that, we're gonna follow up with three rounds of four movements. And these movements will consist of an odd object or any kind of object that you have around you, you can put some kind of weight on. It will be a power clean. All right, just a regular bag. So what I'm gonna do here, power clean means from the ground, and then clean just means you're getting up and over our shoulders, right? So what we're gonna do here, I'm gonna lean over, right? And then bend over, kind of like we're doing yesterday's rows, if you were following up on that. All right, so same position, all right, from here, except instead of doing the row though, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take it straight off the ground. We're gonna come up this way. This is the way the move is gonna look. All right, and then we're gonna catch. Back down, again, and then catch, all right. It's gonna be 30 seconds of that. And again, in slow motion, the way this is gonna look, we're gonna get down. Remember, when we're doing a hip hinge, anytime we're doing a hip hinge, what we call a hip hinge, we're bending at the hips first before the knees. That's a little cue you guys can look on, all right? So that way we're not bending at the knees first and then lack of hip flexion there. So we're gonna bend at the hips first, right? And then follow through with the knees bending as well. We're gonna come down. We're gonna pull this weight. Essentially, what we're gonna be doing is pulling the weight up. In slow motion is what it's gonna look like. We're gonna pull the weight up until we're up in full extension. My glutes are activated here. Pull up into full extension. And then from here, we're gonna shrug up with the weight and then pull the weight up to about here, all right? We're gonna catch there. And then that'll be the movement. Back down, all right? Again, pull up this way, and then get under the weight, and catch, all right? 30 seconds of that. And then it's gonna be 15 lateral, I'll show you this move right now. 15 lateral planks, reaches. They're gonna look like this. You're gonna lean on one side. You're gonna lean on this side completely. You're gonna reach up and then you're gonna reach all the way down and then back up. All right, back down, then back up. If this move is a little too easy for you, or a little too easy for you, you can make it a little more difficult. You can bring the leg up, right? Hold, and then try and go, stabilize, reach. If the move is too difficult, you can come up with your hand here, and then same movement, reach. If that's still too difficult, you can come up on one leg, or on one knee actually, on one knee, and then on my hand itself, you can do the same thing, lean over, and then reach, all right? 15 on one side only, primarily on your weaker side first. If you don't know which one is your weaker side, you probably will find out after this exercise. And then after that, it's gonna be 30 seconds of ad object thrusters. So I get this move here. Remember, we're gonna do the same exact motion that we did before with the cleans, right? With the power cleans. That's gonna be step one. We're gonna go down here, up, catch, and then from here, step two. This is called what we call thrusters. From here, we're gonna go all the way down, squat position, and push all the way up. All right, extend all the way up, down, and I'll back up again a little bit, down, and then all the way up, all right, down, and then all the way up, all right, give me 30 seconds of those, non-stop, I'm gonna hit it, and then that's gonna also, and then after that, we're gonna go with the other side. The other side reaches, all right? It's also a really good stretch at the same time too. All right, and then remember that one's too easy. Bring the leg up, reach. And then if that's too hard, come up this way on one knee, or you could go up on the leg of it, stabilize yourself a little bit, and then come up as well, all right? It's gonna be three rounds of those four movements, okay? Three rounds again of all those four movements that we just went, it's a session, and then you guys should be nice and pumped and ready for the actual workout itself, all right? Hope you guys have fun with the warm-up, okay? Take care, guys. I'll see you in a little bit for the workout.